5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Mr. Speaker, sir, this proposal in a way continues the tax rationalization program that was started by my party in 2004, carried forward in 2006, and further reinforced after we came back to power in 2008. The present tax structure has also been brought down to a level which I regard as realistic and entirely appropriate. I hope this measure will have a salutary effect on our tax culture and will induce the maximum number of taxpayers to come forward and voluntarily declare their true incomes. With the reduction in rates and expeditious disposal of assessments, I believe there can now be two excuses for any leniency to be shown to those who abuse our laws. Such cases will necessarily have to be dealt with severely. In order to discourage tax avoidance and tax evasion, I am also introducing some further measures. In all cases where the annual turnover exceeds rupees 20 lakhs or where the gross receipts from a profession exceed rupees 10 lakhs, I am providing for a compulsory audit of accounts. This is intended to ensure that the books of accounts and other records are properly maintained and faithfully reflect the true income of the taxpayer. I am also proposing that loans or deposits of rupees 10,000 or more shall be taken or accepted only by crossed check or bank draft. I find that the existing provisions of the Income Tax Act provide that no suit to enforce any right relating to any property held benami can be instituted in any court by a person claiming to be the legal owner unless he has declared the income from such property in any return of income or the value of such property in any return of net wealth or furnished a notice in this behalf in the prescribed form to be income tax officer. Such return or notice can at present be given at any time before the suit is filed. With a view to curbing the practice of benami holding of property, I am proposing that it will henceforth be obligatory in all cases to give notice to the Commissioner of Income Tax in the prescribed form within 1 year of the acquisition of the property. This amendment will enable the department to initiate appropriate action in respect of such benami acquisition of property. having dealt with the non-corporate sector, I now turn my attention to the corporate sector. The tax rates for this sector are not being changed. I am, however, providing one facility last year while raising the surcharge payable by companies from 2.5% to 5%, I had given companies the option to make deposits of the additional surcharge with the Industrial Development Bank of India. I am now further providing that companies can henceforth exercise this option in respect of the entire amount of the surcharge payable by them. These resources will flow back to the corporate sector and will be available for modernization. In the earlier part of my speech, I have already referred to the decision to reduce the interest rates on loans up to Rs. 2 crores being extended by IDBI under the soft loan scheme. Some relaxations are also being provided to those engaged in the business of growing and manufacturing tea. The existing provisions provide exemption from tax only in respect of subsidy received for replantation or replacement of tea buses. I am extended this tax exemption to cover subsidy received for further approval schemes relating to rejuvenation and consolidation of areas. I hope this measure will further lend support to our scheme for increasing production of tea. My next proposal, I believe, will be welcomed by a large number of people. Investors presently can receive dividends and interest on debentures without deduction of tax at source if they furnish an exemption certificate from the income tax officer or alternatively file a declaration to the effect that their income for the year is below the exemption limit. To reduce paperwork and avoid inconvenience to small investors, I propose to provide that widely held companies may henceforth pay interest on debentures and dividend income up to Rs. 1000 without deduction of tax at source, provided that the payment is made by an account pay check or bank draft. Mr. Speaker, sir, I notice that certain provisions of tax laws are being misused by a section of the taxpayers. I had occasion last year to deal at some length with taxation of charitable and religious trusts and institutions. I find that some of these trusts and institutions are trying to circumvent the investment pattern for trust funds laid down by the Finance Act 2003. It is necessary to ensure that all such trusts and institutions strictly conform to the prescribed investment pattern. I therefore propose to provide for a fixation of income of defaulting trusts and institutions at the maximum marginal rate of income tax.